Well, hello everyone, I'm Yanni from BUVU Gaming, and today we are back in Banished. So, well, let's just take a little look at where we are at here. We do have wood, we have firewood, looks good. Stone, we definitely need some more. We do have some iron being produced. Am I still producing? No, now we are turning our tools into, or our making iron tools, so I'll have to keep an eye on the iron a little bit, because we only have 52, and of course some of them is being used as we produce more tools. We do have some medicine getting stored. We have a nice supply of food. Okay, 6,000 food, and we don't even have nowhere near 60 people if you look at the 100 food per person per year, so that is good. We almost have, I don't know, we have at least food for 2 years, more than that even. We have 24 people, so yeah. Getting some construction materials and some other random stuff. We have two builders, so let's turn one of them into a laborer. And yes, we have our blacksmiths and everything. Looks like our gatherer's hut is producing a nice big amount of stuff. That is cool. Hunting, still not getting anything from that. And Red Ketchup actually commented on my last video and reminded me why I couldn't actually place my, I was trying to place, was it the windmill or something, or there was something I wanted to place right here, and as you can see I couldn't even put a road in right at that spot. And of course it was because I had placed a tree there, like these decorative trees. So that kind of messed things up for me, and now I'm just kind of thinking, do I want to leave it or do I want to move it? I think we're gonna move it. Yes, let's do that. Remove structures, maybe. There we go. Yes, and then we can fix our road. There we go. Nice. Okay, come. Oh, did I fix you? Okay, there we go. Should have a road coming in there. Nice. Okay, I'm kind of running at a high speed here. What are we running at? 10. Okay, let's go down to 5 and let them do a little bit of stuff. We're also working on the second floor of our colorful little house over here. Got the first one built, we have this one built, and Red Ketchup actually also left the... Okay, we're also building our well out here. There we go, let's get that out there. We do have our well in here, that is awesome. So in case we get a fire, they can actually put it out. But yeah, Red Ketchup commented and said that he is gonna try and add some coasted versions of the trees. Maybe already in the next patch. That would be kind of awesome, because I always miss that a little bit. I would kind of love to have a little tree there maybe. We could have a little tree over by this house. And I already put some of them in, but we are gonna need seedlings, which he also left a comment about, to actually make these little if we go in here, Red Ketchup, let's pause for a second. Storage services, is that the one we need? No. Resources maybe? Let's see, mold house, florist, no. Humory, sand pit, clay pit, kiln, glass maker, can, oh, there's so much stuff to get into here. Foundry, jewelry maker, nope, not what I'm looking for. There should be a greenhouse somewhere that will give us the seedlings that we actually need to build this, or to make these trees. Where is the greenhouse? These are just houses. Oh, right. I actually also added a new mod for this with this video, because Red Ketchup uploaded a new mod which is called the NMT Little Housing 2. And with that one, you get 12 different colors and 7 models per color. They require that you have another mod installed though that produces lumber, they are gonna be added to the Red Ketchup Editor's Choice mod, which is the main mod I'm running here, in a future update, but you can actually add it to your current game shouldn't cause any issues. So these are the houses. You can see all these different colors. We just take a random one. There we go, look at this. Let's turn you around a little bit. And then if you hit F, look at that. We have all these nice different variations of them. Aha, isn't that cool? Yep. And they are meant to kind of be matching the, oh, we got an empty little house toolbar. What is this one called? In comparison. Oh. Okay, click on you. Go over here. Oh, they probably belong together. Okay, so we have these NMT little houses here. And oh, look at all these different types of wood. Awesome. But they are... Oh, NMT multi-level. Okay, so look at that. Oh my, I love the brick color or the colors of this one. We are so gonna have some of these. Oh, they're so gorgeous. Oh, I love these. And then you have, you can put the second storage on these. I remember them from one of my megamod series where they have this. That was just a white version of them. Where you have these multi-level houses. Look at these. Aren't they awesome? Oh, look at this one. Oh, wow. Look at this one with the tower. This is so cool. I love this one. Oh, we are gonna have to build a town out of these. Oh, look at that. And you have one with these colors. Oh, this is so cool. I love this. Then you have the story. Then they have like a tower version or something in the back there. Nice. Oh, look at this. Yep. Got a gorgeous little wooden version here. Okay, what about you? Ooh. I love this. There's so many variations. This is so cool. Look at that. And then we have this one. Nice. Yeah, I think this one looks a little like the ones we had also in that was in a previous mod. But yeah, they look a lot like the medieval. They are like the medieval houses. I don't know if you guys have used that mod before, but there was like the medieval town mod or something it was called by with Ketchup, of course, but that's kind of the same designs, just not with this many different color variations. But yeah, these new colors, these ones are meant to actually match the Boston houses. That's why I wanted to show you guys. So the idea is that all of this is supposed to kind of match together a little bit. But yeah, we're gonna get more into that for now. Let's try not to be so distracted by all of that. Which is impossible when it's me, you know that, guys. Okay, wood. We need more wood. We need more stone. I need them to actually get some resources. Let's try and not mess up this map or this game completely. Oh, look at this. Okay, we have bisons. We have bears. Oh, look at that. There's like... Was that like a baby bear? I think that one is a baby bear. Got small bisons. Okay, we need some trees. Where do we want to cut down trees? Where are we actually going with this map? And yeah, Candy actually left me a comment too, I think, on my first video for the series. Candy from Candy64. I mentioned her in the first video. That with all these lakes that you have around here, then this map would actually be kind of a cool thing to... What's going on down here? We have some animal migration going on across this lake. And we got animals out here. To do something with the canals on this. I'm not sure I'm gonna do that with this map, but I can see the... Definitely see the idea that you can do a canal system running between all of these different lakes. That could kind of be a cool idea. So where are we going? We're gonna have some mining over here, I think. And we have our little fishing area. Okay, we have our forest hub. We're gonna have like the main town is probably gonna be a little bit in here, but we have to remember there's also trading that we want at some point. That will be coming here. Yeah, so it's probably a good idea to kind of start moving our town a little bit in this direction, and then we're gonna have some trading going on over in this area somewhere. So, first of all, we need a tailor. I think that was kind of the idea, actually, at this point. And yes, I still need to get those resources. Just getting myself distracted, as usual, doing 5 things at once in my head anyway. Which one? Did we have a tailor in here, or did we just use the... might just have been this one. Nope. Rosen bridges, magnet trade, not really what I want. Resource production, there we go. Tailor. Yep, there we go. And that has, of course, been updated too, so it kind of matches everything else here. What did I decide? I wanted the light colored roof for the production buildings or something. Looks about right. So, where are we gonna place this? Tailor. We have our blacksmith over there. We do have kind of a little center here. I'm thinking we could kind of place our tailor here, and then eventually when we get some, hopefully some ghosted versions of these trees, we're gonna put some trees in here in the back. That would kind of look nice, wouldn't it? Could also have it running over here. No. We're gonna place you here. Yeah, let's do that. Oop, gonna do that. And then, of course, we need our resources. So, let's get some trees. We should be getting some trees from over here. How are we actually doing? That's this one, right? Forester's Lodge. We have 3 people working. We're getting flowers and fodder thatch from this. But we are getting some logs, too. Also getting some roots and firewood and... Wow, we're getting so many different things. Interesting. Okay, I think that one is fine. That's my gatherer. They're working fine. Let's leave this open a little bit because I'm curious to see what else we get. And I want to see if we're gonna get anything from this hunting cabin. Where is that? That's this one. There were some animals out in this area before. But right now they seem to all kind of have moved away. And I don't know if they're gonna move back, so we might actually have to move our hunter somewhere else. Because we do have, look at all these deers out here. And we have all these animals, so it might be a good idea actually to put a hunter out in this area instead. Yeah, that might end up being an idea. But let's first try in. But if I want a hunter, I might not want to move all the trees in this area. Okay. Let's try and get some trees away up here and there. And we do need some stone. Let's take this. Looks like I've already... Yeah, there's plenty of stone actually still that I have marked somewhere. And stone over here. Yep. Okay. Collect almost all awesome trees. No. Collect iron ore. Which one is the mineral? There we go. Copper and other stuff. Okay, let's see what we can get. Is there anything here? Definitely something here. That looks like copper, maybe. And there was something out here. I think there's some gold right there. Oh-ho. Okay, and then we have our tailor. Okay, we're gonna need some lumber, but we are producing lumber here. Aha. How much lumber do I have? I have 46 lumber. I only need 32. I think for right now we're gonna pause you. There we go. And let's just bring this down to 1 so we don't have someone standing there without a job. Okay. Because I don't want to run out of wood. So let's just do that. And let's speed this up again. Okay, we got someone. Ooh, no, that's just because I removed my lumber, so no one has grown up. But oh, look at that, we got 4 new people. Oh, and someone grew up. Nice. Okay, let's do this. So we have a second builder working. Yep, there we go. The well is getting built out here. That is good in case we get a fire. Nice. Okay, the well is built, and they are building the top floor here. Okay. Very cool. Nice. Okay, and someone moved in there. Awesome. So now we have a second house out here. Yee. Now look at that. Nice. Okay, so now we need this. Well, we do have iron. We still have 46 iron. We do have the stone. We have the lumber. We checked that. We just need them to remove the trees here. So, any reason why you guys are not all the resources here? This is not necessarily trees. It's just any resources, actually. So, let's just say increase priority. Okay. If we can get them to go here, because the problem is right now they're probably trying to... Yeah, there we go. They're gonna go and collect some of the resources I have told them to get everywhere else. Okay, we're bringing over the resources. Nice, we got the lumber, we got the stone, we are gonna get the iron. There we go. Okay, and then the builders should come and work here, hopefully. And they did finish off the little road piece over here, looks like. Nice. Okay, there we go. Now they're working. Ha! Got a tailor. Awesome. So, what can we actually do in here? We can make hide coats. Wool coats. So we're gonna need... Oh, we can do something with cloth. We're gonna need... Ooh, cotton and flax. So, can we actually... Let's see what we have in here. We have feather thatch. What do we have over here? Flowers and stuff. Okay. Didn't I have a barn out here? Was that that one? Yes, forest barn. Mostly food. We can actually put logs in here too. There's herbs in here. There's firewood. Okay, cool. What about out here? Oh, we got a nice supply of fish, mushrooms, and roots in this little granary. Well, we're not producing anything from the hunter yet, so we can't really do much yet. Unless we get some trading going, but that is a little far off if I have to go all the way up here and do some trading yet, so... I think we are gonna... For now I'm gonna leave this hunter out here just to see if it's ever gonna produce anything, but it doesn't really seem like it. But I think we are just gonna leave you for now. And... let's see. But now there's no animal here, animals here again. So how in the world does these hunters work? Because that means now if I try to place someone out here, they won't have any animals again. Which is a problem over here. I was kind of hoping they would migrate into the area again, but that doesn't seem to... Oh, we do have some deers here though. Are you gonna walk into the area? I think this is actually the hunting ring, and this one is from the forester's lodge. Close this down, yes. So it is actually within this area, but it doesn't really... Oh, yes! Haha! As I was saying that, 6 leather, 160 venison. So now we are getting a little bit. They got another one there. Okay, so now they are hunting. I think we're just gonna have to kind of spread some hunting cabins around the map, because the animals do seem to move a lot. I have no idea where all those bisons and bears went. I can hear birds though. We have geese over here. But where all the big animals went. Oh, we got some over here. Oh, nice collection. We have the geese and bears. But where did all my bisons go? Oh, I hear something. There's a bear right there. They are in here. Okay, I don't know if those are the ones that were over here before, but we'll just have to look. Let's see if they're gonna come back, because then we might put a hunter out in this area. But otherwise, I'm thinking maybe further up here. I don't know. Well, we got a little bit of leather. So, let's try and see if we can start making... Yeah, let's just make some hide coats. Just the beginning. Yep, okay. And let's take a look and see. We have two laborers, two buildings. So what is the next thing we want to actually do? We need to get some more working here, but hopefully we're gonna get some more leather and stuff coming in eventually. Trading. Oh, I never found that greenhouse actually. Did I find a greenhouse? I didn't find a greenhouse, did I? Where's the greenhouse? This is all the vanilla stuff, so I don't think that's where it is. It has to be in here somewhere. That's the houses. Then we have the roads. We have storage okay, we've got storage. We've got markets. Well, a market might actually be a good idea. Think about where we want that. Okay, we've got this area out here, but a market sack. Somewhere in the middle might be a good idea. Then we have these buildings. Could choose to go for like a really big city thing. So we have lots of these little buildings. You can see we have a grocery store. Then we have all these little carts. Specialized mini market. As big as a cart, employs 1 to 2 vendors and have a 1500 weight capacity. Okay, it looks like... Oh, that's for textiles. Okay. For crafted, for forged, for fabrics, for materials, constructions, precious, miscellaneous. Okay, we have one for wood. Stone, iron. That's also one way you could get a little extra storage in here, actually. Or make sure that you always get iron brought to this area, because we do have a blacksmith here. So if you're producing your iron somewhere else, you could technically place one of these nearby. And that vendor who will be working here will automatically bring the iron to the area. That can be a handy way, instead of having your laborers having to bring all the iron to a stockpile, for instance. Then you could place one of these down. I do have one cart here in the background. And then we could put one down. I'm kind of... Let's see. No, that looks strange. But we could kind of put one here in the back somewhere. I think I have a tree there maybe again. But I could choose to do it like this. And kind of ignore those trees until later. Till we hopefully get these... let's do that. Yep, there was a tree there. And get these ghosted versions. But trading... Yes. Oh, no. Not what I want. I wanted to go in here. Red ketchup. Go to the... We don't really have a lot of traders for this, but it's just... Or a lot of people for doing this stuff right now. But it's more like just to plan it out. And there's only 8 wood to actually build it. But then we could have like a little trader just kind of here in the back. There we go. So if we place you down there, then that will naturally bring some iron to this area. And since we have this over here, then we could see if we have anything that fits with that. Textile. So I'm thinking that will probably bring... Oh, there's fabrics too. But yeah, that would probably bring the main resources, like cotton, well not cotton, yeah cotton, well not cotton, cloth and leather and stuff to this area maybe. So we could kind of bring, put one of these down somewhere too. So we have one here. Oh, we could actually put one behind, couldn't we? Could leave a little gap between them. I left a little room here because I wanted some trees or something, but then we could put one there. There we go. Nice. We're gonna have a cart textile, cart for iron right there. Yeah, so we have a little bit of trading going on, and then of course you can do the same for food and all that, or we can just go for the big market, which we are probably gonna do somewhere. In the middle, I think. Yeah. Okay, what else? What's the next thing we want to get into here? Well, the school, which is also something that Red Ketchup actually mentioned, is fairly important in this. It can be important in general, but it is fairly important in this mod. So that might be something to choose to look at. The only thing, of course, is that it takes longer before you get more laborers, so it's kind of a balance. But we're doing pretty good with food and all that at the moment, which is actually usually my main concern. That you have to be sure that you're producing enough food to keep up with the population while you don't have that many new laborers coming in. So we might put in a schoolhouse. You have this one. Oh, it's actually, there's one with a fence and one without. Okay, we've got these. Why would we want a schoolhouse? There is also, of course, where is it? Here. You have the medieval school, but we don't have the resources for it. You can see we need like glass and bricks and all kinds of stuff for it. So I think for right now, we're just gonna go for this basic school. Gonna have people out here who wants to go to school. We're gonna have the fishermen. I could choose to put a school out here because their kids are gonna have to travel pretty far for this. We could choose to put the school in the forest actually, but of course it's gonna hurt our little it's gonna take up footprint out here. So I'm thinking eventually we might actually put a school out in this area for later kids. And maybe have like a little miniature society going on out here with the fishing. We could put a little bit of housing maybe over here, or I don't know, some market stuff going on. We'll have to look at that. But for right now, I think we want a school in this area. And that means these people would have to either go over here to go to school, or they can go to here to go to school. Since we have like the main road coming in here, we could choose to kind of have the school over here. Okay, we can't fit you there because that's gonna get interfere with that. Let's get our little fence going. I could choose to have it somewhere here because they will be coming this way through, and then of course we're gonna have people in this area. Today I could pull you back one, and then eventually hopefully maybe we'll even get some bushes or something we could put out front. That could be kind of nice. Okay, we're gonna put you here, and then we are gonna put this. Yeah, I don't know how much of it is gonna work when it gets patched, you know, because that's always the deal with some of these mods, that when they get patched sometimes it can interfere with your current save game. But let's just assume that eventually we're gonna get some stuff, some trees and stuff that might be able to put on that little footprint there. So, okay, so now we have our carts coming in. That's just a little bit of logs. That should be fine. We have our schoolhouse. Let's put that in, and then a hospital could be a really good idea, but we need lumber for it. We're gonna need bricks and glass, so that's something we need to look into. A town hall could be really nice too. Need some special resources. We have a chapel for happiness. That could be a good idea. Cemetery is always a good idea. How old is our people? 40 and 37. 43, 36. It might be a good idea to start thinking about where to place a cemetery actually. Because otherwise they're gonna get unhappy when everybody dies, when all the old people are gonna die. Kind of thinking maybe over here next to the school. So we're gonna have a little area here where we're gonna have a school and a cemetery. Maybe we'll have a church out in this area somewhere. And they do go to the cemetery every now and then. So It's also a good idea to not have it too far away from the town. Yeah. Okay, so you are there. Let's leave a little room. And cemetery is too small. How big do you have to be? Like this. Well, we're gonna have a fairly big town here. So I'm thinking it's gonna take some stone though, but let's see. How wide is that thing? Looks like it's a 2. Yeah, so we want an even number to get it in the middle, and then you can just kind of hit R to move the entrance to where you want it. Okay, if we go like 20, we have a fairly big cemetery going here, and it with enough room that we could have a little path or something in behind it. 20 by 20, that's fairly big. We're gonna need 76 stone for that. Okay, we're gonna go for it. We're just gonna go for it, guys. There we go. Now we just need, we have iron, we have everything we need for this. Okay, this little cart is done. Let's put you over here. I not really have the, well, we do have people, but I don't really want to place them there because we're gonna need someone to be a teacher. And right now, we're producing everything we need. We're producing the iron right next to it, but it's more later if you put a foundry or something in there. Ah, we have a bear right there in town. We've got bears out here, yeah. I'm thinking it might be a good place. We still haven't gotten a lot of new leather here. So I'm thinking out here might be a really good place to put in a hunter instead of the other one. We have two people working there. I could decide to take one of them out and just kind of leave one just because we already have it. Or I could choose to remove it. But I am thinking that a... Okay, do we have a different one here? Food. Creamery. Oh, that's the greenhouse actually. We need glass for that. Greenhouse is used to plant seeds and grow vegetables. But yeah, this one will give us seedlings that we can use for those decorative trees. Not a priority right now. Yeah, I'm not seeing any other hunter, so I think we're just gonna go for... But I kind of like that, actually. He's redesigned these, the all the vanilla buildings, so they match the mod. But at the same time, he hasn't really added anything to exchange them, so they still have a function. Whereas I feel like before, I would often kind of just skip out on all the vanilla buildings because it was much more interesting to use the modded versions. I kind of like this. They still have a use now, and it feels like you really want to build them, actually. Okay, hunter. Focus. Hunter. There we go. Hunting cabin. Do we have any... No, there's only one version of this, but yeah. You can see we have deers out here. We have the bears here, so I'm thinking this could be a good place. Do we have anything across the water? Well, I don't really want them to walk across the water because that can be a bad thing actually. So I might want to put it up here a little bit sometimes, or I might put a little, we could put a little bridge in. So is there any animals over here along the little shoreline here? Let's see. I'm not seeing anything. I do see some nests, but that is about it. And I kind of like to have them down here. Okay, we have geese over there. Okay, so I could choose to build it a little bit here. Then we have the geese, we have the deers, we have the bears covered. So do something like this. Yep. And yeah, let's just let you face this way. And we're gonna build a hunting cabin. Gonna need a road going in front of this. I've been trying to give them extra space though, so let's bring it up one and let's see if we can meet this road out here. There we go. Nice. And then I am gonna now I can't see where I placed it that well. Okay, here. Yes, that looks about right. Nope. Then we're gonna bring it out here. There we go. Then let's just see what we have when it comes to bridge. We have a wooden bridge. Do we have any other bridges? What kind of transport bar? Then we have sandstone road, we have sand brick road, we have red brick road. We need bricks for this, we need bricks for this, we need bricks for this, it looks like. So, no, not really what I want. So far it doesn't seem like we have any other options for, like, bridges. So let's just go for this one. Wooden bridge. There we go, where are we? I think it's right here. So I would want to bring that across here. Just so they don't... Usually it's not really a problem, but they have a tendency to, if there's gonna be animals over here and they want to go here to hunt, they will have to cross the water, and sometimes that will cause them to walk a long way around to try and get around it, or they'll try and walk over the water and kind of get stuck or something. So let's just give them a bridge. There we go. Nice. Oh, our textile cart is getting built. Yeah, we don't really need them right now, but they're so cheap, so let's just leave that. They are working on removing all of this. We're gonna get a ton of resources from this. How are we doing with this stockpile here? Oh, 60% full. Plenty of room. Okay, and we do have this little one here. Stockpile iron. We just have one iron on that. Stockpile minerals. Yes, we are running out of iron. Do we need iron for any of this? We just need stone. We have the 12 iron for the schoolhouse. They are gonna finish this off. We need stone, we need stone. Okay. Let's go and get a little bit more stone somewhere. Okay, let's just see. Is there any more stone? There's a little bit of stone way over there. Got some stone way down here. Got a little bit, one little stone by there. We got a stone there. Got some stone over here. There we go, nice. Let's get this stone. Cool. And trees, we are doing fairly okay with that right now. I think we're doing good with tools, so let's just do this. You're gonna get a lot of iron ore in here, so let's just make some iron while we're doing good with the tools. Okay, cart textile. Let's move you over here. Okay, so we are slowly progressing here, guys. Hopefully I'm not gonna fail at this. I'm so good at, for instance, running out of food in this game. I know we have plenty of food right now, but that can change in like a split second. I do notice that firewood, we are actually going down. We only have 354 firewood. So let's put an extra person in here. There we go. You'll be working on that. Do we need lumber for anything? No. So we're gonna leave the lumber mill off. And we are gonna get our house built. Oh, our school built is almost done. We're gonna work on this graveyard. And we actually need... Well, the cemetery is not our highest priority. The hunting cabin would actually be higher priority. Okay, well, we are gonna have to continue with this next time. I'm already out of time. Yeah, I don't know, with Banished, it's always one of the hard games to make short episodes. I always want to, I can easily play for an hour. But I am trying to get better at this, getting the videos a little shorter. I'm not gonna promise that it's gonna happen every single time at all. But yeah, thank you for watching, guys. And as always, do take care and... Happy gaming!